everybody, and welcome back. Today, we have a lot of cool things, so let's get started. We're going to be making strawberry popsicles. So wash your hands and meet me back at the kitchen. For today's popsicles, you'll need some frozen strawberries, some honey, popsicle molds, and apple juice. You can switch out the strawberries for any fruit you want. So let's first start by taking a bag of frozen strawberries. I got these from Walmart for about a dollar and some change, but I'm going to pour about half of the bag depending on how big your popsicle molds are. So I'm going to pour about half a bag of strawberries, just like this. Next, I'm going to add a half cup of apple juice, you guys. So here I use a 1/4 cup, so that's why I use two of them, but I added a half a cup of apple juice. Next, I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of honey. This is what's gonna give you that little bit of sweetness. Fruit already has natural sugars, but just to give it a little bit more of a sweeter taste, that's also a little bit more healthier than all of the sugar that people dump in to popsicles or smoothies, we're going to add honey like this. Next, we're gonna blend. And blend, 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 blend until your mixture is smooth. Now, if you need help with the blender, be sure to ask an adult for help because the blades in the blender are very sharp, you guys. And this is what it should look like before you pour. Next, I'm going to take my popsicle molds. I got these from Walmart as well. These were $1.98 for 2 penguin molds. Really cool, huh? And it comes with a really cool lid. So next, I'm going to pour the mixture into both of them. Now, depending on, like I said in the beginning, depending on how big your popsicle molds are, will depend on how much mixture you have. I did have some leftover, but what I ended up doing was after these froze, I poured the leftover inside so I could have 4 popsicles. But this is a pretty big mold, you guys. So I'm gonna pat all of the air bubbles out like this and freeze them for about 5 to 6 hours. This is what they look like when they are frozen. So all you have to do now is just enjoy them. Thanks for watching. Hope you try it out, and I hope you guys enjoy. Next up, we're gonna head to the art room and see what's going on. Welcome to the art room, you guys. Today we're gonna make some paper fortune tellers. Let's get our material and get started. What you'll need is some scissors, a piece of paper, and something to write with. First, you're gonna take your paper and fold 1 corner directly down to meet the middle of the paper to make an even triangle like this. Next, you're going to cut the excess paper off at the bottom. This should leave you with a perfect square. So open it up and check it out. Awesome. Next, you are going to fold the opposite way directly down the middle or towards the side to make an X or a kite-shaped line in the middle of your paper. Next, you're going to fold each end or each point to the center of your paper just like this. Every one of them are meeting in the center, you guys. Make sure you smooth the lines too. Just like that, so you should have a square. Then you're going to flip the paper over backwards and do the same thing. Just like this. Fold each corner to the center. So at this point, you should have a smaller square, but it should still be square shaped. Just like that, guys. Next, you are going to fold in half. Now, it doesn't matter if you fold towards the front or the back. So it doesn't matter if you fold with the flaps going inward or going outward. All that matters is that you make the fold or the crease so the paper can fold in those ways. So here you just see me playing around with folding it. And now I'm going to stick my fingers through the slots in the back that we created. And I'm going to begin to mold the fortune teller, guys. Meaning I'm going to begin to pull all of the corners together in the center like so. And play around with it a little bit so I can get used to opening the paper and closing the paper in different directions. And so the paper can be used to bending and folding and being pulled that way. After I've gotten the paper adjusted, I'm going to then begin to decorate and write on. I'm going to write purple, orange, green, and red on each of the square flaps. And then on the inside, I'm going to label 1 through 8 on all of the triangles, or the triangular pieces, I should say. I'm going to decorate it really nice. I'm going to put some hearts, maybe some polka dots. Guys, make sure you personalize it. This is your artwork, so put your all in your best in it. And make it unique. Let's be creative. So instead of things like fortunes, I put really cool things like, you are awesome, you will do great this school year, or questions like, what do you want to do this summer? Or what have you accomplished this summer? So after that, I am done, you guys. It is a really cool thing to make. So if you guys make them, please tag us in them so we can see your awesome creations. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you guys again. Bye, guys. But before you guys go, let's do a quick brain teaser. So today's brain teaser is I Spy. Have you ever played it? I'm going to give you guys things. You have to find the words beep, beep, beep. You have to find a cat. You have to find 2 fish and a truck, a paintbrush and a yellow duck. Let's go. Time's up. Did you get it right? Well, thanks for playing and thanks for watching. See you guys next time.